Mixing It, presented by Mark Russell and Robert Sandor.
Hello, tonight's programme has a faintly ambient theme running through it, with a new track by the young god of electronic noodling, the Aphex Twin, some previously unreleased material from Fripp and Eno, as well as ambiently inflected works by more unfamiliar names, Jam and Spoon, Disco Inferno and Toop and Eastley.
But we start proceedings distinctly unambiently with a band who were once described as San Francisco's answer to Henry Cow. They started life in the 70s as a progressive rock quartet, unpromisingly called Cartoon. In 1988, they shed a member and became PFS. Out went the classical bombast, and in came a leaner, more improvisational approach. And that comes over pretty clearly on this track from their album 279, called The Road to Rome. PFS with The Road to Rome, and although that's from their album called 279, we actually played it from the Cuneiform Sampler number one. That's a sampler of lots of artists on the Cuneiform label, and I have to say it's an excellent sampler. We could have pretty much played any of the 21 tracks. They seem to be a label dedicated to collecting Mixing It sort of music from all around the globe.
So we shall hunt them down in the near future. Now, we've played music by the Aphex Twin twice before on this show, and we've admired its textural originality, formal austerity and bracingly chilly feel. But that stuff sounded like disposable pop music compared to the Twins' latest release. Selected Ambient Works Volume 2 is a double CD containing 154 minutes of electronic music so abstract that none of the 24 pieces even get titles. Instead, their creator, a young Cornishman, Richard James, has illustrated them on the CD sleeve with colour photographs, mainly unrecognisable blow-ups of unrecognisable details of things you probably wouldn't recognise anyway. Well, we get the point. This is ambient music that aims to create its own highly cerebral environment rather than evoking airports, supermarkets or space stations. It's mood music for moods that haven't been felt yet. And for those who like to dance, the Aphex Twin will keep you waiting around for quite a while before the beat gets going, as it does here, sort of. Disc 1, track 9. Thank you.
The Aphex Twin with track 9, CD 1, and that's from his collection Selected Ambient Works, Volume 2, which is on the Warp label. Funnily enough, after you'd said all that, Robert, I mean, we did actually manage to pick the most commercial track, I think, off the 2-CD set.
Yes, I think if they were hoping for a hit single off that vast double album, that would have to be the track. I mean, a lot of it is really much more closely related to the sort of experimental avant-garde work of people like Cage and Reich in the 1960s than it is to any pop music I've ever heard. Now, the man who taught the rock world how to chill out with ambient music was, of course, Brian Eno, so it's entirely appropriate that Virgin should be remarketing Eno's catalogue at a time when the genre is becoming so saleable. The latest item to resurface is a single CD compilation of his work with the guitarist Robert Fripp, which contains a series of pieces that have never been released before, Healthy Colours 1 to 4. The story goes that these formed part of an album Fripp and Eno began in 1978, but never finished, mainly because of Eno's commitment to Talking Heads, and more specifically his growing partnership with the group's leader, David Byrne. Interestingly enough, the themes of Healthy Colours seem uncannily prescient of the albums Eno went on to record with Byrne, and in particular the blend of funk riffs and musique concrète on 1981's My Life in the Bush of Ghosts. Well, see what you think. This is Healthy Colours 3.
Off and get it. I'm just trying to let you talk long enough so I can detect your motives. The only reason I want to... Not love. You say my motive is to help Ed Lamb sell his book, period, not comma.
Guy, to have him come on. Why do we have just people come on? Why is it always somebody that's got to make a buck come on here? Why?
Has earned $600 million.
Never enough.
Now wait a minute.
From the album The Essential Fripp and Eno on the Virgin Venture label, that was Robert Fripp guitar and Brian Eno, I supposed almost everything else, with a track called Healthy Colours 3, a previously unreleased recording that they did back in 1978, and it really isn't showing its age, is it?
It isn't. It amazed me that it was 1978, because so much of the so many of the aspects that we associate with ambient, for example, the plinky little drum sounds and the repetition, they were doing back then.
I know, and that's what makes you realise what a bold thing the Aphex Twin does, in a way, that he's a good deal less adventurous than they were.
Now, we have something of an oddity. James Young was the keyboard player for Nico from the time she left the Velvet Underground right up until her death in 1988. His book, Nico, Songs They Never Play on the Radio, published by Arrow, tells the eventful story of life on the road during the 80s. And now, on the Creation label, James Young has released a soundtrack to the book, songs which illustrate particular events from it. He's written all the songs except for this peculiar reworking of a Schubert lead, Der Lyreman. Young actually sent us a copy of the album, and in his fascinating letter he analysed the component parts of his arrangement. And I think it's actually worth pointing some of them out beforehand, as they make quite a difference when you listen to the track. Der Lyreman was an organ grinder, often a gypsy or Jew, who in the 19th century was considered an outcast. Apparently Schubert, writing this at the end of his life, very much identified with this character. Young has made the sample of Jewish ram's horns one of his recurring motifs, along with Varum from the Brahms motet of the same name, which means why. The vocal samples are Nico intoning This Is a German Song, and the sound of neo-Nazis chanting Germany for Germans, foreigners out, after they'd burnt down a Turkish hostel last year. All within one of Schubert's most beautiful songs, the final part of his song cycle, Winterreiser. Here it's sung by countertenor Nicholas Clapton.
This is a German song. Thank you.
Der Lyreman by Schubert, arranged by James Young from his album Songs They Never Play on the Radio. And that's on the Creation Records label. I think that's a very poignant assemblage of elements there, but I really think you need to know beforehand what they all are to get the effect of it.
And from what I've read of the book in which James Young recounts what happened with him when he was playing in Nico's band, I think that was a much more orderly performance than any of the ones he ever managed when she was alive. Well, you can't really call it rock music or dance or jazz or any of those other familiar friendly names. It's Disco Inferno, a British trio who, insofar as they ever deal in reference points, sometimes sound like a chaotic reinvention of Joy Division. Mostly, though, they create a quite distinctive musical world of their own, pivoted around guitarist Ian Krause and the separate MIDI systems he's hooked onto each of his instrument's six strings. Hitting one unleashes an instant torrent of samples, hitting two presages the apocalypse, hitting three introduces a familiar twangy sound, and so on. It's edgy, unsettling music, the virus in electronic music's seamless dream, one reviewer wrote recently, a comment that makes rather more sense after you've heard Disco Inferno at work. So here they come now. This is Starbound. Yes, it was another of our whimsical segues. What started out as Disco Inferno ended up with Jam and Spoon, a pair of German dance remixers in an ambient mood, sharing Disco Inferno's liking for the sound of camera shutters. First you heard Starbound by Disco Inferno from their album D.I. Go Pop on the Rough Trade label, and then came LSD Nikon from the album Tripomatic Fairy Tales 2002, and that's on the Epic label, and it's by Jam and Spoon.
Now to something completely different, as they say. If you've ever been to WOMAD festivals in this country, then maybe you've been lucky enough to see the larger-than-life Qawwali singer Nusrat Fateh Ali Khan. And if you have, you'll know just what a compelling performer he is. Happily, unlike many live performance-based artists, his vibrancy and sheer enthusiasm really does translate to record. He and his 10-piece backing group from Pakistan have just put out a full-length CD of 4 songs. And it's a marvel of group interplay and all-round effortless virtuosity, whether it's on vocals, tabla, harmonium, or even hand claps. Qawwali is the devotional music of the Sufi Muslims, so here's an extract from their epic 22-minute homage to the Sufi saint Baba Farid Shakar Gunj. It's called Ganj-e-Shakar.
Yeah! ਸ਼ਕਰ ਤੋਂ ਸਦਕੇ ਜਾਵਾਂ ਚਿਸ਼ਤੀ ਸੋਨਾ ਰੰਗ ਚੜਾਵੇ ਸ਼ਾਨ ਫਰੀ ਦੇ ਗੰਜ ਸ਼ਕਰ ਦੀ ਮੈਂ ਚਾਦਰ
ਸੋਹਣੇ ਬਾਬਾ ਦੀ ਮੈਂ ਚਾਦਰ ਸੋਹਣੇ ਬਾਬਾ ਦੀ ਮੇਰਾ ਦਿਲ ਮੇਰੀ ਜਾਨ ਫਰੀ ਦੇ ਮੈਂ ਚਾਦਰ ਸੋਹਣੇ ਬਾਬਾ ਦੀ ਮੈਂ ਚਾਦਰ ਸੋਹਣੇ ਬਾਬਾ ਦੀ ਸਾਬਿਰ ਦਾ ਪੀਰ ਸੋਹਣਾ ਗੰਜੇ ਸ਼ਕਰ ਸਾਬਿਰ ਦਾ ਪੀਰ ਸੋਹਣਾ ਗੰਜੇ ਸ਼ਕਰ
ਹੈ ਬੇਮਿਸਾਲ ਬਾਬਾ ਪੀਰ ਕਮਾਲ ਬਾਬਾ
ਹੈ ਬੇਮਿਸਾਲ ਬਾਬਾ ਪੀਰ ਕਮਾਲ ਬਾਬਾ
ਸਭੀ ਲਜਪਾਲ ਮੇਰਾ ਗੰਜੇ ਸ਼ਕਰ ਬਾਬਾ ਗੰਜੇ ਸ਼ਕਰ ਮੇਰਾ ਗੰਜੇ ਸ਼ਕਰ ਗੀਤ ਸੁਣਾਵੀ
Yeah.
band, what a sublime double whammy to end tonight's show with. First, in order of appearance there, you heard Nusrat Fateh Ali Khan with a track from his new album, The Last Prophet, on the Real World label. That track was called Ganj-e-Shaka. And then there was Toop and Eastley with the title track of their album, Buried Dreams, which will be out in about a couple of weeks' time on the Beyond Records label.
And as always, all the tracks we played tonight feature on our playlist. If you want a copy of it, send a stamped addressed envelope to Mixing It, 16 Langham Street, London W1A1AA, and the details are on CFAX page 642. And before we go, it's time to reinstate our fabulous Mixing It poster offer. If you'd like one of these sought-after items, send in two first-class stamps and you'll get the poster. Good night.
Good night.
Mixing It was presented by Robert Sandell and Mark Russell and produced by Philip Tagney.